According to the 2011 index, over 70% of the Israeli public is not satisfied with the government's handling of the state problem. What does this mean?
Well, this figure of over 70% of the people in Israel who are dissatisfied with the handling of the state affairs by the government is indeed very troubling, because we expect in democratic regime that the public would endorse the way that the government is dealing with the state problems. This, in fact, point to a large pocket of dissatisfaction on the level of the Israeli public. And I must add here that this dissatisfaction is almost equally distributed between the Jewish population and the Arab population. It seems that almost everyone is dissatisfied with the functioning of the government right now.
The data for the 2011 index was collected before the social economic protest of the summer. An additional survey was conducted in September to see if any differences were found. Were there any significant differences?
Well, indeed, we have conducted two polls. One was conducted before the emergence of the socio-economic protest in the summer of 2011. The original poll was conducted in March 2011. And in September, we have conducted a mini survey in order to find out whether there were some massive differences in public opinion on the issues dealt with at the 2011 original survey. Amazingly enough, on most issues, there were very little differences between the before and the after. Level of satisfaction with the government functioning was about the same. However, there were several changes which may raise some concern at a certain level. The first difference was that whereas in March 2011, about 28% thought that the socio-economic issues are the most important for the government to deal with, in September, over 40% thought, following the protest, of course, thought that this should be the first issue to be dealt with by the government. The second in line in March was the IDF ability to deal with the defense challenges. This was put as a second target of the government, but in September it dropped significantly from 22% in March to only 8.5% in September. This means that the entire issue of defense is considered, following the protest, much less important than it used to be in March and, of course, in past years.
What can we learn about the relations between Jews and Arabs in Israel from the findings of the 2011 Israeli Democracy Index?
The major issue that is important in regard to the Jewish-Arab relations and was exposed in this survey was the very wide gap between the principal adherence to democratic ideas and principles and norms and the practical translation into the Jewish-Arab relations level. Apparently, most Israelis, Jews and Arabs alike, are strongly in favor of the theoretical issues of freedom of assembly, freedom of speech, equal civil rights, and so on and so forth. However, when you translate it into the practical level of the rights of the Arabs in Israel, we do see some very troubling findings on the level of the Israeli Jewish mainstream. For example, there is a majority which thinks that Arabs should not be included in the decision-making as far as critical decisions for Israel are concerned. We thought that this would have impact only on the security peace-related issues, but we found out that there is a very large majority of the Jews who think that there needs to be a Jewish majority in order to make decisions also on the societal, economic, and governmental level. And this, of course, means the exclusion of Israeli Arabs from a very major filled that in a proper democracy this cannot be acceptable.
What findings would you be glad to see in the 2012 index?
Well, apparently my personal opinion here is as good as anyone else, but of course I would like to see, for example, a further reduction in the number of Israelis who would see the strong leader as the best regime for Israel. In the past we had almost 45% who thought that this is very good for Israel. In the 2011 we saw that it dropped down to only one third, and hopefully we will see less of this in the future. Obviously I would really like to see the bridging of the gap mentioned earlier between the theoretical adherence to democratic norms and principles and the practical implementation, mainly in the realm of the Israeli Arabs-Israeli-Jews relations.